Hi everyone, and today is third episode, and today is Creative Quarantine Challenge. So my name is Sneha from SBO School and Junior College, and presently I'm in 12th grade. And my hobbies are, I'm a typical badminton player, even though I don't look like one, but still. So, and I'm good in art. So these are the two things which I go on with each other on each day.
Hello, this is Inmozhi from Chennai Public School. I'm studying in grade 11. My hobbies would include dancing, doing silambam, painting, and we're really good friends, so we share most of our interests. And today, on the third episode of Quarantine Challenge, we have the theme as gratitude. So to start about, what is gratitude? It's just feeling grateful for what you have, what you've attained all this long. So now let us get into the first activity of this quarantine challenge on the theme gratitude. So this activity is, what is gratitude? So our first question would be, what is gratitude according to you? According to you, what do you think gratitude is?
So the second question for the viewers is, what are the elements in the nature which you think you're very grateful for? Just, you can write it down in a paper and then send it to us.
So our next activity, activity 2, is called Alphabet Gratitude. So we'll play the game now so you'll understand what we're going to do.
Alphabet R.
R. Rice.
Cool. Okay.
So I'm grateful for having food here, for having to eat so much food all these years.
Nice. The next alphabet may be W.
Water.
Nice. Cool.
I would like to ask alphabet M.
M. Meat.
Meat. Okay.
Yeah, it's actually your
favorite food for
yeah,
you.
Yes.
Okay. C.
Care.
Care. Okay. So this is the alphabet gratitude activity. So here basically in your house you can play this activity with your family, where one of you ask an alphabet and you ask for what, and any word with starting with an alphabet that would that you're grateful for having in your life. So that's basically this activity. So you can play this activity with your parents or with your children, and I think it'll make you think more about how grateful you are.
And now the activity 3 is gratitude jar. So idhila pathina enna, veetla you can maintain a jar. So in that, each day a person in the family can write a note for whom they are thankful for, maybe within their family members. So they can write it in a note and put it in the jar. So it can be done by all the members in the family. So once the jar gets filled, they all can sit together and read out and check about and know about people for whom they're thankful for. So this helps us to know about people, what they think and for whom they're grateful for.
And also we can write about what in that what quality in that person we are thankful for, so that in a family we don't usually say thanks, or we don't share our emotions as much as we share with other friends. So this activity would probably bring out the feelings of everyone in the family. And this can also be, the jar can also be decorated by the kids with any kind of material, and probably this can be done in a more innovative way. The kids would have more ideas. So this would definitely be a really good activity. So now we move on to activity 4, which is gratitude photograph. So this would probably have you digging into your old albums and checking out your nostalgic moments. And in this, you go out and find out photographs either of your childhood or your parents' childhood, where you find out a photo where either your mom is feeding or your sister is helping you out studying, or you're playing with your friends or anything, where another person is showing so much gratitude to you. So you take that photo, you can either make a video of all these photos, speak about how grateful you feel for them helping you out at that time, or either write it down in a paper with all your feelings into the paper on how grateful you feel for having these people around you in your life.
we move on to activity 5. So it's Nature Gratitude Garland. So in this name, you have got the entire idea of the program. So it is a garland in which you can make it out with things like maybe a trash, with pictures. So these are the elements for which you're grateful for. With all the elements which you feel you're very grateful for, you can make a design, or you can make it in a very innovative way. So with all these elements, you're going to make it out a garland. So that is all about this activity. So now we're going to see about what are the things that you can use in that garland.
You can either draw out things you would actually be grateful for in your life, or make small crafts out of trash, and anything you are grateful for, maybe you can like make small paper crafts which are designs of what you're thankful for, and then make a garland of it, and then you can actually visualize what actually makes up your whole life. Okay, so we've arrived at the end of the episode, and just to make a note here about why we should do these activities at home. We'll all be in our homes together now. So I would like to share that it's really important to be as a family and to share time with your family, especially when you get time like this. So nowadays there's no connection between the members of the family when everyone's in separate rooms using mobiles or playing games. But since there are no sharing of moments or happiness within the family, I feel these kind of activities would actually be a start for having a happy life together as a family. And
so now, we being the very present generation, we have not experienced what our mother or father has experienced in their childhood. So only when you sit together with your family members and talk about, and when they share about their experiences, we get to know, okay, life is about these things. Okay, they've experienced such a kind of experience. So when they share about the prestigious words and all the things which they did, you can gain some experience and you know the real meaning of what life is.
Okay, so we've seen what we need to do, but how are we going to do this? So basically, you have this WhatsApp number. To this number, if you just reply that you've seen this video and you're willing to participate, you will get a code. This code will be your code for all the episodes of this activity. And anything you do in these tasks, anything you have done, or all the tasks you have done, just send a picture or a video or the write-up, anything, to this number with your code, so that you will be given points points on your activities. And in case your points are good enough, then probably you will be able to enter the leaderboard, for which you will be rewarded. The gist about the video is in a document form, also called an activity document, is in the description link. So you can either read through it to, you know, understand the activities more precisely, or take a printout and understand the activities and make sure you do this activity in a really good way. You can click on the description of this video to find out the WhatsApp group invite link for the parents to not miss out on any videos which are going to upload. And
please do subscribe this channel. Please share it with your friends and let people also participate and get rewards.
Are you ready for the creative quarantine challenge?